Hi, I'm Teresa Jackson. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a photo grid like this with Lightroom Classic. The first thing you'll want to do is create a collection. I have a collection here of flowers, and we'll use these flowers to create the grid. You'll want enough images in your collection to fill the grid, whatever size it is you're going to make. I actually have more images than I need for the grid we're going to create. And I did that on purpose so I can explain how it works when you have extra images or not enough images. The next thing you'll want to do is select that collection with all the images and switch to the print module. I need to open my top panel group here and switch to the print module. And yours might look something like this, depending on the printer that you have, if you have a printer attached, what the paper size is that was defaulted to. The first thing that we need to do to create this grid is to create a custom piece of paper. We're not actually going to print this on paper, but we're going to create a custom sheet size for our grid. So we do that over here under Page Setup. Click on Page Setup, and we can do this for any printer. I have a Stylus Pro 3800 attached. We're not actually going to print it, so it doesn't matter. Yours will look a little bit different depending on the printer that you have, but you should have the option to create a custom size. So when I go to paper size, I'm coming down here to manage custom sizes, and I want to create a new custom size, and we're going to create a square grid. It's just easier to work with these if we work with whole numbers. And it really doesn't matter as long as the height and width are the same size. The bigger the page setup, the higher resolution image you'll be able to export. So I'm going to make this 20 inches, which is really quite large. We'll have lots of pixels when we're done to print whatever size we want. And the next thing we want to do is take out all the margins because we're not actually printing. We're going to create an image. And then I'll rename my custom size to the size so I know what it is when I have it selected. And we'll say OK. And then it has that paper size selected, so I'll say OK. And we'll see in the overlay here that it says paper size at 20 by 20. If you don't see the information overlay that shows the paper size, press the I on your keyboard and you can toggle that on and off. Okay, the next thing we need to do is take a look at our print options over here. Starting from the top, we want it to be on single image contact sheet. And in the image settings, we'll turn on zoom to fill and turn off rotate to fit. And you may want a border between your images. We can always come back to this later, but I'm gonna go ahead and choose stroke border, change the stroke border to white, and I'll change it to 2 points. After we create the grid, we can determine if that works or not. Next, we'll come down here to layout. We'll look at all these panels. In the layout, we don't want any margins. What we want to do is create a grid, and we do that here with rows and columns. So to create a square grid, you need the same amount of rows and columns. I'm going to create this at 12 by 12. That'll give us 144 images on the sheet. Now we're only seeing the one flower because only one image is selected in the film strip. Notice here in the toolbar it says use selected photos. If we change this to all film strip photos, it will fill that up. But we're looking at page 202. Remember, I had more images that were needed for this. So the first page will be full. Let's collapse all of this. We don't need to be looking at all of that. We have a collection of 194 images. Right now we're looking at page 2 of 2. If I back up using this arrow here, we'll look at the first page. So this has 144 of the images. If I want to create two sets of grids, I need to put 288 images in the collection. We're just going to create the one grid, but that's why I put extra images in there so you can see how that works. It's automatically going to create the number of pages that you need to fill all of the images in your collection. Let's keep going down here. We don't need to show guides. If you turn them on, it's hard to see what you're looking at. So I'll just turn off the show guides. And in this page panel, turn everything off. We don't want to put any kind of text or copy in this. So make sure all of those are off. This is where we're going to create the image. But before we do that, we want to save all of this work so that we can come back to it, maybe put different images into it. In the upper right-hand corner, it says Create Saved Print. I'll click that. And what this is going to do, it's going to create a special kind of collection. So we want to give it a name. So we'll call this Photo Grid 12 by 12, so we know what it is. And then because it's a collection, we can choose a location for it. I'm going to put it inside of my Photo Grid collection set that I have over here in my collections. And then choose Create. And notice that we have a new collection that has this printer icon on it because it's a special kind of collection. Now that we have the print grid set up, I might want to edit this a little bit to adjust the position of the images. You can select on any cell and just move that image around. Because these weren't pre-cropped, Lightroom is automatically filling those to the center of that square cell. If you want to get in closer to an image, like this flower here, you can switch over to the Develop module with the D key and then give it a crop. I can go ahead and give this a square crop by choosing the format here to square and then just crop it in a little bit closer. And as soon as I switch back to the print module, that fills that cell perfectly. So if you want control over how your images fill the cells, you'll want to crop them first. The next thing is I might want to adjust the order of the images because I don't like these two so similar sitting on top of each other. So what we can do then is switch to the grid mode or the grid view with the G key and then just find the images that are next to each other that maybe I want to separate. Just dragging and dropping. Down here in the toolbar, we want to make sure this says custom order. So you can take some time to really go around and adjust these, switch back to the print module, see how that looks. We have some similar ones here. So I'll select this image. You can adjust them in the film strip as well. I just find with the grid, you can see the entire grid. So sometimes it's easier to do it that way. Notice as soon as I drag this image over, it moved it in the grid. Now we have two similar looking photos here, so I'll move that over. So you can spend some time really fine tuning that to your taste. Now we're ready to print this out to a file. Over here at the bottom of the print module, it says print to. Yours might say printer if you're hooked up to a printer. We're going to switch this to say JPEG and then choose a file resolution depending on how big of an image you need. I don't want a big image for this, so I changed the file resolution to 100 ppi. So at 20 inches by 20 inches, it'll be 100 ppi. And then the profile, we want sRGB for something that I can share this on social media. We'll click print to file to create that image and give it a name. Now, the thing that this is going to do is create two files because I had two pages and there's no way to have it print just one page. So if I only wanted one file, I should delete all the images out of this photo grid collection over 144 images because 12 by 12 is 144. So I jumped out to my desktop and we see the two grids that were created. I only really need the first one. We'll take a look at the second one and see that there weren't enough images to fill that entire page. But this first one, let's close this out, look at the first one. This one looks fantastic, don't you think? So I hope you found this fun and useful. What kind of photo grid will you make?